Been hanging out with my family. I've been doing a lot of fishing back home. I mean, of course, there's not a lot of things open, you know. Of course, one thing I am happy about is the fishing stores are still open, so that didn't stop me there from fishing. But you know, it's just a, you know, obviously it's a bummer, you know, how this whole thing happened. It's sad to say, you know, we were sitting there at Daytona, we're all like, you know, we kept hearing a little bit about it, we're like, oh, there's no way, it would get this big, and the next thing you know, like, dude, a week later, then bam, you know what I mean? Everything got shut down, like basically shut the whole world down, and it's real sad in a lot of ways just to see how things happen. But, you know, at the same time, we're all like, man, like, we kind of needed that little break, but we didn't want this long of a break, you know? Like, you know, definitely one thing about 450 class, you know, when you're racing 17 weeks straight, you know, it's a lot on you, or 16 weeks straight, it's a lot on you. And, you know, like I said, we were like, oh, you know, it was nice to get a little weekend off. We're like, but we're ready to go back racing, you know? And, you know, I guess I would say, like, nothing, mainly, man. Like I said, just fishing and hanging out with the family. Been doing a little bit of barbecuing, gotten into that. Hanging out with my nephews and just, you know, been getting them into fishing and stuff. And it's so cool, like I said, to finally get my nephew to catch one little, like, he caught a little bluegill. And he thought it was the coolest thing in the world. So, just, you know, like I said, being a family, being like to get to see my family again, hanging out with my grandma and all that stuff. So it's always good to get to see those people again. And when you're on the road, like, you know how the game is. You're nonstop. Your mind's programmed for one thing and one thing only. It's all about racing. And that's all you think. You know, you eat, sleep, and, you know, think about racing. And, you know, then when you finally take a step back and with this, you know, like I said, it's a real bad tragic. But then on the other side is you get to do little, catch up on little things, you know, like the little things that you were like, oh, I'll just do it whenever the season's in. But now you can do it, you know. So that's pretty much all I got. And, you know, we're supposed to be racing here soon in the May. Yeah, so, you know, we got the message from the Feld, and Feld obviously got it from the government that we're supposedly supposed to be racing at the end of May. You know, I'm not even going to sit here and lie about it. That same exact message I was supposed to hear 2 months ago, you know, and it's really, it's nobody's fault. It's just how the world's come to you right now. And, you know, at we're all trying to do the right thing, and, you know, we all want to go back racing, but at the same time, health comes first. So, long as everybody can start working together, we can get these numbers down, you know, stop spreading all this this virus, and then, you know, we all can go back racing, because there's no need to go back racing until, you know, this thing calms down. And like I said, I'm 100% agree with, you know, the way the government works and stuff like that. I understand, and when it comes to health issues and Yeah, of course, like, we're athletes, you know, we can deal with that. We get sick on the regular, you know, we're always dealing with it. But for people who are not familiar with this and doesn't, you know, never had the flu or been sick, it's a different vibe for those guys. So for me, yeah, it's the same message. Like, we've been hearing the same thing. We've all been kind of training for it, and we're training. It's almost like it's like a fighter training for this fight, and then, you know, that fighter got hurt, and now it's like, oh, we're going to flip in another slot where you got pushed back. So it's kind of like a, you know. But yeah, again, it's kind of like we've all been kind of been, at least I will say, I'm not sure what everybody else, but I've just been kind of just keeping it at like 60%, because you don't want to burn yourself out. Like, if we don't race until September, you know, I'm definitely going to take some time off. But I've been doing just enough to where, you know, we're trying to keep ourselves in shape in case we do race in the May. So I'm hoping we do, because I'm ready to get this over with. you know, and we just got back riding this week, and this is probably one of the coolest things in the world, to get back racing or riding again. Just throwing my leg over a motorcycle, that whole fun feeling of it doing again. I love every bit of that. And like I said, we're just trying to figure out if we're going to go racing or not. I guess whenever we do go racing, we won't, you know, it's a reset. It's like Anaheim 1 for all of us again, you know. But the downfall about it is the turnaround is going to be pretty quick. So what this key factor is really going to be more, it's not like, don't get me wrong, you can't mess up on Saturday night anyways, but it's more like you can't make any mistake, because you got another race in like 2 days or 3 days or, you know, less than a week. So the turnaround is really quick, and that's when recovery is going to come in. It's all going to be those factors of how fast can you recover to get yourself back ready for another 20-minute race, you know? So, I'm excited. I'm ready. I mean, that's what we, you know, that's why I have a trainer for Garrett Swanepoel, and I feel like I got my whole crew that's, you know, ready for this. So we'll see if it pays off or not. Do I like California? Hey, I won't say this. So I came out here. I flew out here Sunday. A couple of my buddies were like, oh, you know, you gotta wear a mask and stuff like that. And I'm like, yeah. You know, in Florida, nobody wears a mask. Everybody just does whatever they want to do. Florida's a whole different vibe out here. So I didn't get a chance to go to the grocery store. Came off a flight. I was so tired. I went to sleep. I was at Starbucks. I was riding Monday morning, and I got kicked out of Starbucks for not having a mask on. And the lady was like, everybody, you know, the funny thing is, you know how you walk in and it's like the old Western where the guy walks through the double doors and everybody's at the bar talking, they just turn and look at him. That's how I felt. I was like, what y'all looking at? Y'all see something you like? You know, what's wrong with you? And then, like, I walk in, I was like, yeah, Malcolm, because I called it in. And the lady was like looking at me like I was some zombie. And I'm like, Malcolm, like, you know, and she's like, you can't be in here. I'm like, what do you mean, why I can't be in here? She's like, you don't have a mask. I'm like, you're right. I got a beard though, so does this work? And then she's like, you gotta get out. You gotta get out. I'm like, I'm not leaving without my drink. So either you can follow me with my drink, but I'm getting my drink. I paid for it. That you know, that was $6.95. That's a nice drink. And I got a Trenta, so I want my drink. You know what I mean? So I got my drink after I waited outside for it, but I told myself I'm never going back to that Starbucks again. So I haven't went back since. Fun fact. Tony Alessi called me, and he's like, hey, we're going back racing. It's supposed to be May 15th, and I'm like, all right, okay. He goes, I need you out here Sunday so we can get ready to back ride on Monday. I'm like, cool. You know, I was already itching and scratching to be back riding anyways. So, and he's like, I'm like, perfect. This would be a good opportunity for me just to go out and just, you know, just get my feet wet and have some fun again. And I get out here, and the day comes, and then we're like, it's now May 31st. I'm like, I wasn't expecting to be out here for a month. You know, I didn't bring everything, but you know, whatever. It's all cool. But that's just more time for me to ride my motorcycle, so I'm not really tripping over it. It's what we do it for a living. But yeah, I'm like I said, I'm really excited just to, if this thing does really kick off again. I'm not sure what's really happening. Everybody's just kind of sitting on the bubble. We're all hoping and shooting for it. But you know, if things don't go the way it goes, and looks like we're gonna be ready for September. I'm cool with either one of them. I mean, I would rather race now because we're already in shape and ready to go. And you know, if it doesn't, we kind of have to just restart. And plus too, like if we race in September, you gotta do the math. Like if you race start in September, you won't end until October, which means probably no Monster Cup, no overseas races, and then turn around January 1st, you know, Anaheim's right there. So it will just make the next 2021 season so much longer because you practically got to get ready for September, which is really, you know, it's not really a time off. So that's why everybody kind of wants to race now so we don't have to do it later. But plus too, like Monster Cup is all cool, you know how that goes. Like it'd be cool to do Monster Cup and, you know, to go watch whenever the the pick three riders designations, and see that stuff go on and like stuff. Like there's so much other things that, you know, you want to see happen, but if it's the way the world is, the way the government is, like, you know, like I said, at the end of the day, health comes first. So I'm cool with either one of it.